All right. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Wednesday night Bible study here at King Solomon Baptist Church. Welcome and greetings in the name of Jesus Christ. Father in heaven, thank you for allowing us to be here. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for one more opportunity to be in your presence. Thank you for another opportunity to share your word with your people. Thank you for this resurrection week. Thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross, pay the price for our sins. So we thank you and we welcome you into this fellowship for the next 30 minutes. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, good evening, everybody. I'm glad to be back this week. Took a little vacation last week, and Pastor Greg Ragland, our virtual internet technology pastor, taught last week. He did a real good job. I was able to tune in. Even though I wasn't here, I was able to tune in and hear him on last week, and he did an awesome job. And so we thank God for him and for his ministry and for standing in for us. And so we're back this week, ready to rock and roll. We're so excited because this Sunday is Resurrection Sunday. It's the Sunday when we recognize the resurrection from the dead of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And I pray wherever you are that you will be in somebody's church this Sunday, and if not in church, you'll be on somebody's phone or iPad watching somebody in church. So we're just thankful for this week of the resurrection, of the Passover, all of that, those things that are relevant to what we call Easter Sunday and Easter Sunday week. Amen. So tonight, I want to talk to you for just the next few minutes, about, I really don't have a subject, but I know what I want to talk about. So I'm going to give you a scripture. The book of Psalms, chapter 9 and verse number 12. Psalms chapter 9 and verse number 12. Amen. Listen to this here. It says, "So teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom." And what I want to zoom in on is the first part of this verse, what says, "Teach us to number our days." Lord kind of been dealing with me with this for the last few days, and I think it's relevant. It's always relevant, but I think even more so now in this time that we're living in, And so many people are passing away, and so much is going on, and the world is still in a certain level of chaos, and we know the chaos is getting better, but I think this past year, I know for me, and I'm sure for a lot of you, this past year has brought me to a place to reassess my life. And I think if you care anything about yourself, it has probably brought you to a place where you're reassessing some things in your life. And, you know, for myself, I'm reassessing what I want to get done in this life. There's some things I want to do. There's some places I want to go. There's some things I want to do on my own. There's some things I want to do as it relates to ministry. There are some places I want to go. You know, I want to visit all 50 states. I have a goal of trying to hit all 7 continents. I'm going to get it done one way or the other. And maybe you have some goals and some dreams, and you want to get those things done in this lifetime. And so I think, once again, I think all of us, if you haven't been, I want to encourage you to take this season and take a bad and turn it into good. Take this season and reassess your life and your goals and your dreams and make sure that you're living your life to accomplish those things and get them done, okay? So this scripture, and Moses actually is the one that wrote this. He says, "Teach us to number our days." So he's telling us a couple of things. When he says number our days, he's speaking to our life and for all of us to make sure that as we live our life, we're getting the most out of it. Now, I don't know what you may be 40. I don't know what you've been doing the last 39 years. But listen, from this day going forward, why don't you make a decision tonight that the next 40 years are going to be better than the last 40 years? Or maybe you're 50 or you're 60, and up to now, you really haven't enjoyed life. Well, I want you to do what I'm doing in some areas and what other people are doing in some areas. It's make a decision that the last 20, 30, or whatever years of my life are going to be better than the last 60 years of my life. And I'm telling you, if you make that decision, then your life will get better. But I promise you, if you don't make a decision to change, then nothing is going to change. You have to make a quality decision that I'm going to change my life for the better. So Moses is telling us to number our days. That means keep track of them. And like I said, it's in the context of making sure your days are useful and that your days are fruitful. And so that word number, I extracted two things out of there that I'm going to share with you tonight. The first one is, for those of you that may have just come on, I'm out of Psalms chapter 9 and verse number 12. The first thing about this word number is that it tells us that we have to acknowledge that life is temporary. Amen. That's why I said number your days. That means it's not going to last forever. So here's the first thing I want to share with you. This life is not going to last forever. Watch this here. You're going to die one day. Amen. You are going to die one day. You might, unless you're here when the rapture occurs. You might not want to die. Oh, but you're going to die. You might not like dying, but you're going to die. And trust me, they're not going to run out of caskets. We'll find somewhere to put you in. But I assure you this, you are going to die. And Moses, old man, is telling you tonight to number your days because this life is temporary and we were never intended to come here and stay forever, especially after the fall of Adam. You know, you're going to die one day. So make that a resolute understanding in your thinking. I'm going to die. My mortal existence is going to disappear one day. Amen. You're not going to be here always. So understand that. So he's telling you to number your days. The other thing about the word number I want us to get tonight, not only should we acknowledge that life is temporary, but we also should not acknowledge the brevity of life. B-R-E-V-I-T-Y. What I mean by that? We not only is life temporary, but we're not going to be here that long. That life doesn't last that long. And when he says this, he's saying it in comparison to eternity. Eternity, you really can't conceive with your mind because it has no end and it has no beginning. Eternity is just eternity. So we live in time, and time comes out of eternity. So time will one day wrap up, and then there will be nothing but eternity, which was here before. So in eternity, you have God, you have angels, you have demons, you have the devil. All that's in eternity. We live in time. And so in time, your time here on planet Earth, it's not going to be that long. Because what's this, 70, 80 years? That ain't even a drop of water on the clock of eternity. So life is short. You're not going to be here that long. Matter of fact, I think James said that your life, it ain't nothing but a vapor that appears for a moment and vanishes away. Amen. So remember that. You're not going to be here long, you're not going to stay here, and you're not going to be here long. And in light of that, he's telling us to number our days, meaning, watch this here, make good use of your days. Make good use of the time that God has given you. Make sure, do everything you can to be at peace. Do everything you can to show love towards people. Do everything you can to, like in the army, in the old army, be all you can be. Amen. Don't waste your life mad. Don't waste your life being angry. Don't waste your life being upset. Don't be wasting your life having an attitude with everybody. Don't waste your life not accomplishing things that you know you ought to be accomplishing. If you want to go to school and you believe God wants you to go to school, listen, now is the time for you to go to school. If you want to get you a house, now is the time to go and get you a house. If you need to get rid of that raggedy car and get you another car, go and get you another car. If you want to go on a vacation, take a vacation. Whatever your heart's desire. And why do I say that? Because God promised you to give you, if you have delighted yourself in him, he promises to give you the desires of your heart. Amen. And so if whatever the desire of your heart is, that God-given desire, Moses is telling us tonight to number your days. You're not going to be here forever. You're not going to be here long. So the time that you do have, you don't need to be wasting none of it. Now, if you're like me, you can waste a whole lot of time and money. Amen. So I know y'all ain't no better than me. So I know y'all done wasted time and y'all done wasted money. But watch this here. All of us have got to stop and assess and say, where am I in this thing of life? Amen. Where am I? And of course, you know, the older you get, you know, the clock is running out on you. And so assess where we are and then begin to make those changes. Make those changes to create the type of life that we want. Amen. If you're at a certain age, I ain't gonna put no number on it because somebody get mad, but I'm gonna put it. So say if you're my age, I'm gonna be 55. You 55 and older, I'm telling you, the clock is running out on you. It's running out. If you 85 and you don't hear tonight, I got some news for you. The clock is really running out on you. Amen. The clock is running out. So all of us, especially those of us that are older, we have to really look at our life and make sure that we are enjoying it and getting out of this time that God has given. Because God is the one that gave you the time. So make sure we're getting out of this time that God has given us, the things we want to do, the things we want to accomplish. Listen, don't never retire on life. You might retire from the bank, but don't retire on life. Keep dreaming. Keep envisioning things. Keep wanting to conquer something. Amen. You don't have to stop. Watch this here. When they came into the promised land, Joshua and Caleb, was it Caleb? I think it was Caleb. Caleb took Mount Samaria at 80 years old. He was 80 years old and went out there and took a mountain. So listen, that lets me know that it doesn't matter how old you are, you don't have to stop living. You don't have to stop enjoying your life. Keep enjoying it. So as we get older, it becomes more critical that we do that because our time is running out and our strength is running out because we can't do what we used to do. And for my young people, amen, those that are younger, I think it's even more important for you because sometimes when you're younger, you think you're going to live forever. Amen. I know I did when I was 18, 19, 20. I would drink like a fish. I would drive like a dummy. Amen. And hang out all times of night doing with all these other dummies. Amen. So I wasted a lot of time. I wasted a lot of money. I wasted a lot of energy. Why? Because when you're young, you think that you're going to live forever and your parents are in their 50s and 60s and you don't have enough sense to realize that's going to be you one day. And so if you're young, let me encourage you tonight. Listen, number your days. Let me go back to my notes. Moses is talking to you tonight too. Number your days. You only get to be 21 one time. Don't mess it up. If you mess up your 20s, you're going to pay for it in your 30s. If you mess up in your 30s, you're going to pay for it in your 40s. If you mess up in your 40s, you're going to pay for it in your 50s. So what's happening? You're doing things at a younger age that's going to cost you at a later age. Amen. So this applies to you. So number your days. Make your days good days. Don't waste your 20s drinking, getting high, in the club, chasing some crazy man, chasing some crazy woman that a man don't want you anyway. Taking every dime you got and spending it and going in debt and buying stuff you can't afford. I mean, you 21 years old and you got a Camaro Z28 with a 600 horsepower engine. What you gonna do with that other than kill yourself out here on the interstate? Huh? So watch this. So be wise. Listen, be wise. Listen to those that are older so they can tell you how to deal with your 20s. You know how I know that? Because you ain't never been in your 20s, but they have. Amen. So why don't you ask some people who have been in their 20s and you can learn a whole lot of wisdom just by talking to them. Amen. So my young people, I want to encourage you. I'm almost up. I want to encourage you tonight. Quit wasting your time. Count the days because you're not going to get them back. If you drop out of college, listen, yeah, you can go back, but it's real hard going back to college at 40 when you got a husband or a wife and 2-3 never-head kids running around. So while you 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, get that college education. Serve in the military. Do it right. Amen. Go to the police academy. Go to the firefighters academy. Be an Indian chief. Whatever you want to do. Get it done when you're young and when you have the energy, when you have the strength. And that's a good way to keep a good count of your days. Why? Because you made the best benefit out of the time that God gave you. And I'm going to give you this warning. I'm going to leave it alone. Because if you mess them 20s up, listen to what I'm telling you. You mess them 20s up, some of the stuff you mess up, you're going to be paying for it in your 40s. Listen to what I'm telling you. You mess them 20s up, you go out here and rob somebody, or commit some crime at 25, you're going to be paying for it when you're 45. Amen. You go get that IRG, go get that Corvette. I know it's $115,000 now because I went and looked at one. And I numbered my days and said, oh, no. I ain't going to give them all that time. But you're going to get you one of them $115,000 2020 Corvette, and you're going to finance it for they'll do 8 years on you now. You go finance it for 8 years, you better number your days. Because you're 25 in that Corvette. But I promise you, by the time you're 33, you're going to be trying to get married. But you're going to have this $2,000 Corvette payment you got to keep on paying. And your new wife ain't going to like that because she's going to want some furniture and some dishes. You better listen to me. Amen. So number your days. Be wise with it. And so here we go. As I get ready to go. Moses said, teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Psalm 9 and chapter 12. I'm giving you my scripture again. So we talked to you about acknowledging life is temporary, acknowledging that life is short. So it's two things I want to emphasize to you. And this is really where the Lord wanted me to go tonight. Number one, in order to really number your days, knowing you're going to pass away from here, is you must give your life to Christ. And I know it's an old message, and a lot of folks don't want to hear it. And they criticize Jesus. They only want, they try to turn Easter and bring up these conspiracy theories. Well, Easter, we know Easter is a pagan word. I'm not worried about that. He was rose from the dead. Amen. It's Resurrection Sunday. But let me tell you something. The only remedy you have for your sin, the only remedy you have for every lie you ever told, for every act of fornication you ever committed, for all the gossiping you've done, for all the bad thoughts you have thought, because you've done something. I promise you, you done something that convicted you in your heart. Amen. And if you've ever been convicted of anything, you got dirt on you. Amen. Everybody done something. The only remedy for that is the saving power of Jesus Christ and his blood. So that's my one, that's one number one or two points. Give your life to Christ. If you don't know Christ, make that decision tonight. Romans 10, 9 and 10. It says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Everybody stands in need of a Savior. That's the only remedy, amen, to the condition of mankind is Jesus Christ. All you have to do is believe in your heart and confess it out of your mouth that God, that Jesus was the Son of God and God raised him from the dead, he crucified him on the cross, paid the price for our sin. You believe that from your heart, God will save you. And he'll come into your heart, give you his Holy Spirit. You'll be a new self. Amen. You'll be brand new. And he'll give you his Holy Spirit to help you live the Christian life. And you know what I like? This is what I like about God. When you come to him, he don't go and do the math on you. Because I'm telling you, if you did the math on me, the math wouldn't be looking too good. And if you did the math on you, I don't care how good you've been. You can't walk that many old ladies across the street and be good enough for God. If he do the math on you, you'd be done too. Amen. But he is so gracious that if you come to him in Jesus' name, he'll forgive you and he will treat you like you ain't never done nothing wrong. Your mama ain't going to be that good to you. Because your mama, they'll bring it back up. Now, remember when you were saying, and we loaned you that $20. Okay, mama, I remember. Okay, give her $20. But Jesus, he doesn't do that. He doesn't bring your past back up. He doesn't consult your past to determine your future. Amen. He will bless you to prosper right where you at. Amen. He will bless you to increase right. He will give you a promotion right where you at. He'll put more money in your pocket right where you are at. Amen. Why? Because, first of all, he ain't looking at you anyhow. He's looking at Jesus. He ain't even looking at you. It ain't even about you no more. So if you don't know Christ, number your days. Know they're running out. Know you need a Savior and give your life to Christ. Second thing, and my last thing, not only should we give our life to Christ, but for all of my Christian friends out there, all of my believers out there, we are believers. For all my Christian friends out there, the next thing that we need to do to number our days is to make sure that we are serving him while we have a chance. Amen. While we have a chance, we should be giving God all that we can. It's no sense in being a Christian and you ain't doing nothing connected to a local church. You ought to be doing something somewhere. Whether you can sing, whether you're an usher, whether you're a greeter, whether you like to do outreach, whether you like to sow, listen, we have got to give God everything we can while we have a chance. Number your day, because watch this. I don't want to get to my deathbed, and I know it's coming. I mean, there's a cliff over there, and you keep driving like there ain't no cliff over there. I don't want to get to my deathbed, and I'm laying there, can't go nowhere. Amen. Because most of you, when I die, I want to die in a nice warm bed. Well, put me in that group too. I don't want to die in no plane crash, no car wreck. Amen. Put me in a warm bed somewhere. I don't want to get to that place in life and be laying there knowing in my heart I did not give God my best. Because now I'm in a position where I can't do no more. And I got to look back and reflect back over my life and realize I didn't give God my best. Because I promise you, when you get in that deathbed, how much money you got in the bank, that don't even matter no more. Nobody care nothing about that except your kids. Because see, behind your back while you lying there dying or whatever you dying of, they doing the math on your bank account. They doing it. Yes, they are. They doing the math on your bank account. Well, you know, daddy got an IRA, daddy got a retirement, daddy got a county region, bank with me. Oh, they doing the math. But my kids love you. Yeah, they love you, but they still doing the math. You better be real. And Rock said, because you done it before. Amen. Somebody leave you something, you doing some math somewhere. Amen. So, watch this here. So, the only thing that's going to matter, your money ain't going to matter, your property ain't going to matter, your relationships are not going to matter, because you're going to lose all of that. The only thing that's going to matter is what did I do for the Lord? What did I do to make a difference for the kingdom of God? Amen. Because when in that moment, you're going to have a very real consciousness of your mortality. Amen. Not even what you did in this world as a good person. That stuff don't mean nothing. It's only what I do for Christ that is going to last. It is what I've done for him and by accepting him in my last moments of my life. That's the only thing that's going to be relevant. And then you know what? When you know you can die like that, then you close your eyes in peace and don't even worry about it. You close your eyes and you tell the mortician, don't even put a smile on my face. I'm going to take care of that for him. And you can pass away. But if you ain't been doing what you know you're supposed to do, you didn't number your days, you waste your time, you wasted you about 79 before you start doing something in church. Now we appreciate a 79-year-old doing something. But when you 79, 89, 90, it ain't going to be too much you can do. We say, go ahead and hold up the sign, and it's 100 degrees. You ain't going to do that. We ain't going to have to do that because you can't do that. So watch this. Number your days. Serve God while you have a chance. Know that you have a limited amount of time. Don't waste your time. I'm going to say it again to my young people. Don't waste your time. Don't waste your time with people who don't even like you. Don't waste your time in audiences and crowds of people who don't even like you. They really don't even want you around. Amen. They just want to make money off of you. Come on. Don't waste your time with boyfriends and girlfriends and you know they ain't going nowhere. Come on. You understand what I'm saying? I mean, he ain't got a job. Why you hanging around him? Number your days and get rid of him. Come on. I'm sorry. So, young people, number your days. Take full advantage of the time God has given you. Amen. And make, watch this. Make life work for you instead of life making you work. There's a big difference. Because in one, you enjoy it. In the other one, it's not so much fun. I'm done for tonight. Listen, we'll be here Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Resurrection Sunday, 10 a.m. in the sanctuary, Facebook Live. We're still wearing masks. We're still social distancing. We're still screening at the door, but we're going to be in here. We got a room. We haven't really had a capacity based on the governor's last direction. I think it doesn't matter who comes. I think we're going to have plenty of room. Amen. So if you want to come to church this Sunday, make sure you got your mask on. We'll screen you at the door. Listen, we start at 10 o'clock. Amen. Don't come up here at 10:05. I mean, you can come. We'll let you in, But we start at 10 o'clock, and nearly every Sunday since the pandemic's been going on, we've been out of here at 11 a.m. So we welcome anybody, wherever you are, you can come in here with us, or you can listen on Facebook Live, and let's celebrate Jesus Christ. He's the one that has made a difference in my life and the life of so many people worldwide. So let's enjoy Resurrection Sunday. We're going to have a good time. We got three or four young people that are going to say some little small Easter speeches right in the middle of service. It's going to be great. We're going to have a good time. Praise and worship is going to be going on. Dr. Brian Cole and our praise team choir is going to be bringing some good singing. We're going to have a good time in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Listen, I want to encourage you, if you think you need to get the vaccine, and I think they over here in Arkansas, they opened up to almost everybody 14, 16 years old or something like that. Go get the vaccine if you feel you need it. If you don't need the vaccine, then that's fine. Don't get it. I say this here. Be wise in whatever you do and allow the Lord to order your steps. I got to go. Listen, we walk by faith and not by sight. God bless you this day and always.